So yeah, this voiceover stuff is not that very hard, I have to say. So let's continue with the story time. How not to travel with a DiscoverEU pass. So yeah, let's visit Lisbon, we said. It will be fun. And we can use our DiscoverEU passes, which we won a month ago, to travel back our countries from there. A free journey back, and we can visit several countries on the way back home. Hell yeah! I love the European Union. Let's visit Switzerland too on the way back home. I'm pretty sure it won't be that expensive if we have the rail pass. Sure, it will be amazing. You know what? I have a better idea. We don't need to buy the reservations for the sleeper from Lisbon to Madrid. I'm pretty sure there will be plenty of space on that train. Sure, why not? Nothing can go wrong with it. We stayed for 7 days in Lisbon last August. On the second day, we went to the main train station to
Lisboa Santa Polonia
to pick up the last person of our group. And then, we headed to the counter to reserve the tickets to Madrid. Let me imitate how it happened. Hello, we would like to reserve 3 bed for the sleeper which departs on the 24th of August to Madrid. And after a short silence, we got this answer. The train is full for 2 weeks, there is no space on it. And we stood there like, and now what? Just to remember, our project was to travel back from Lisbon to Budapest, via Madrid, Barcelona, Lyon, Geneva, Zurich, Munich and Vienna. It was 4 days before we wanted to leave Portugal. And we stood there like, okay, no problem, we will figure something out. You probably know the feeling when you don't want to make your homework and leave it for the last day. Yes, we did the same. Lisbon is beautiful and Portugal is an amazing country. If you don't know where you want to go, then go there. The infrastructure is unique, the weather is hot, and perfect for both relax and explore. But back to the story. The days passed by, and we left this problem for the last day. The last day. We sat in the same room, and we all opened Skyscanner and Kiwi to search flights from Portugal, but everything was too expensive. It was nearly impossible to leave Portugal by flight. The cheapest Ryanair ticket was 200 euro or more, so way more expensive than we expected. After 2 hours of searching, we suddenly got an idea. The good old bus company, Flixbus.
Flixbus.
What? I see this as an absolute win.
Hooray! We found a ticket which is not expensive and take us overnight to Madrid. We went to the shop to buy food for the trip and headed to the
Oriente
train station to catch our Flixbus departing from there. It was 10 o'clock in the evening, darkness and a little bit of chilly cold outside. You can only hear the many, many long distance buses departing. And 80 people, including us, waiting for the green bus to come to successfully take us across the border to Spain. The bus departs in an hour. It's probably parking somewhere else. Let's wait. Suddenly, the 80 people who's waiting got a message on their phones. Today's service is replaced by a white Iberia bus, but the schedule doesn't change. You can hear the other 76 people whispering in the background. But you're still filled with hope that you can continue this amazing journey you planned for weeks at home. The bus departs in half an hour. Still nothing, the bus is nowhere. But on the little boarding pass you print at home, they say to show up before 30 minutes. You start to panic. Some things happen. It's 10:30 and you're still not on the bus. No problem. Probably it's not a big problem. Let's wait for more. 11 p.m. departure time. The bus is nowhere. The the last bus us who departed, only us, 4, and the other 76 people, are on the platform. It's time to call the Flixbus support. It took another hour to reach the support and ask what's going on.
Do you like this? Do you like this? Well, no more.
Yes, our Flixbus got cancelled. We had to catch a taxi and went back our accommodation. It was 2:30 at night and we were tired. Too tired to think of something. So we chose the first solution we could think of. A flight. A Lufthansa flight, which can take us from Portugal. No, this is not enough. We need to twist the story more. We booked a Lufthansa flight, not from Lisbon, but from Porto, which is 100 km away from where we are. The flight departs in 8 hours, and we haven't slept yet. How did we manage to sleep 2 hours, then run across Portugal? How we all our plans and still manage to visit Switzerland? Well, that's for another video. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this video. See you again in the next one.